I'm Eric Peterman.
And I'm Britta Peterman, and we attend the Rolling Meadows campus. I grew up in a Christian home, and so faith for me was something that was just embedded in my life. But it really wasn't until I was in college that I began to have a relationship with the Lord.
I grew up in a Christian home as well. I played sports through high school and into college, and I got connected with Fellowship of Christian Athletes. That's really where my faith, I think, became my own.
Eric and I both were athletes, and so it's actually where we met, was in FCA.
After I had graduated from college, I played football professionally for a couple years for the Chicago Bears.
After grad school and living in the city for a couple years, we got married and we started off in wedded bliss. Our firstborn, Elijah Ted Peterman, was born March 17th, 2016. His first few months of life were a whirlwind.
I was extremely excited to have a boy so that I could coach his football team, and everything was going great.
Was at our four-month appointment with him, just a normal kind of routine follow checkup, that our pediatrician just started getting a little worried. He was not really meeting some of his growth milestones. They wanted to intentionally hospitalize to run some tests on him. Eric and I were planners, we're doers. We're kind of like, okay, let's just check this off the list and we'll kind of get on with our little family. What was supposed to be one overnight stay turned into a couple nights. They started finding some things in blood work. He was having seizures. He had seizures for 3 days in the hospital. He lost his vision. He lost the ability to eat, and he lost all of his muscle control after the seizures. They led us to go get genetic testing.
I remember sitting in the geneticist's office, getting the results back, saying that a gene mutation from Britta and a gene mutation from Eric happened to get together and produce muscular dystrophy for our son. It's literally one in 100 million or more of chances that this would happen.
His type was so rare, but something that should affect his limbs, but Eli's was affecting his brain. His brain was actually shrinking over the years.
Our future that we thought we had with an athletic, healthy kid, it was just rocked.
As Eli's life progressed, it became more and more difficult. There was more treatments, more and more surgeries, medications. 2020 brought its own challenges, and so we were in the hospital when the world shut down. Our doctors looked at us every day and said, "We have to get you home." They knew the hospital was about to be at capacity. They didn't want us there anymore, but we didn't have a way to get home. There was no way to control his pain without a special medication that could only be given at the hospital.
He just cried nonstop. And I'll never forget just holding him in my arms and just breaking my heart because there's nothing I could do to stop this pain. Just thinking like, God, why? Like, help, help.
It felt really hopeless. We didn't have an end in sight. We began attending Harvest right before Eli was born, and we were placed in the most amazing and purposeful small group. The community of people the Lord put in our life really kind of carried us through a lot of our years with Eli. We'd come home to a freezer stocked of food, my pantry cleaned out and organized. Their prayer and their willingness to continue to show up and help us, that really kind of helped carry us through. As we continued to pray and use our community, the Lord provided an answer, and it kind of came to our hospital staff one day to enter Eli into hospice care.
Most people think about hospice when your grandma or grandpa are end of life, and to put a three-year-old into hospice was not something I ever thought I'd have to do.
As the weeks kind of went on while we were at home, we saw some really good days. We saw some smiles again. But then he started to show us some signs. His lungs were shutting down and his body just began to shut down. I'll never forget, even in that moment, you know, when the hospice staff are sitting and kind of telling us this, my first instinct, of course, is to fix. It's to take control of the situation. The nurses had gotten to know us pretty well. They knew our faith. They knew our story. And they just said, when the Lord's calling him home, it's time to go. Something you never want to have to do for your own kids. But after the years that we got with Eli, we knew when the Lord was ready for him. We wanted Eli to be able to run into those arms. It was 2020. The world was shut down. We couldn't do a funeral. We couldn't do a normal goodbye. We were thankful for Harvest that they allowed us to do a small funeral of just our family. We were able to bury Eli just a few blocks from our home. So it's a place that we still get to go and see him. It's now been 2 years since Eli has passed. we've started to do a lot of processing and healing through that and trying to figure out all, you know, the whirlwind that the Lord was teaching and doing in our lives through all of that. And the Lord was really teaching us, I think, through Eli's life to surrender, that the control piece is not ours. It was the Lord's. He had a plan and he had a hand in it all. And if we let it go and we surrendered, we put it at the foot of the Lord, that's where we felt like the peace and joy. Since Eli's passed, we welcomed another beautiful daughter, Jenna Joy. We're super thankful and blessed to have another daughter, another healthy daughter. And just keeping up with the two of them is keeping us pretty busy the last year.
Elijah never spoke a word in his life. He never spoke the gospel to anybody. But through the life that God gave him and the 4 years that God gave him on this earth, he's touched so many people. He's showed God to so many people. We've run marathons for muscular dystrophy to raise support. We've spoken Elijah's story to WGN News.
Every year in April, we have an Honor Eli Day, and it's a day where we ask people to share what makes them brave, what brings them joy, or to spread some joy or bravery to other people.
It's an opportunity for us to give back to others that are experiencing some of the pain, but also an opportunity to talk about Eli's story and to point that back to God.
It's still a journey that we're on. I don't think the Lord's anywhere near done with us yet, but we know that the Lord gave us a story. The Lord gave us Eli. We were so blessed and lucky to be his parents. Our goal for the rest of our life is for sure to sing the Lord's praises through him.